trying to show them something that's a bit pretty or a bit more pure. Because although a lot of, when you look at our show and you listen to the lyrics, you feel there's an element of sort of a darkness and sadness and that, but we're dealing with a very sort of a real side of what love and life is about. And sex shows and strip shows are quite sort of sad and that they're very frivolous and that this is what women are about and they're not, you know. So it was like, I mean, being very aesthetic now, right? But it was like trying to bring something beautiful into that sort of pretty heavy context. And also I like, I'm attracted to that seedy side of life, just visually, you know what I mean?
Each man kills the thing he loves. Each man kills the thing he loves.
I'm always suspicious of people who are in music and they think they are actors, painters, writers, etc. After, I used to be in a band called The Virgin Prunes, which I ended around late 85. And after that, I went away from the whole music thing and painted for a year and a half, and it was very productive for me. I found it very self-disciplining, and I did an exhibition and things like that. But it was after the exhibition I wanted to get involved in music again, and I don't think the two go hand in hand. If you want to paint, I think you should just paint, go away and paint. If you want to write, if you want to make music, you should just do one thing. But it's still like a big love of my life, and I'm sure one day I'll, when I knock this on the head or whatever I do, I don't know, I'll paint for a long time. But I don't believe in these characters that can do everything, you know what I mean? I think you've got to concentrate. It sort of takes away from art I'm multifaceted vibe, you know, I don't like that.
The first single from the album is the title track, Each Man Kills the Thing He Loves. It's not like, if you read the poem, it's quite a remorse and intense and sad lyric. But we didn't see it like that. We gave it almost a sort of a joyous type of vaudevillian sort of circus type of a feel, because love is like a bloody circus. People running around like clowns after each other, falling in love and breaking their hearts and not knowing who or what they are or where they're going.
You mentioned The Virgin Prunes, which most people know you best from. Mm-hmm. Why did you end that?
Well, it's like most things. I mean, that band started it sort of inspired by the whole punk movement in 77. And around 84, the whole spontaneity just fizzled out. And most music's only live a certain life, and then it becomes a big cliche, and we were beginning to become a cliche, I thought. It was like our elements of how we sort of dabbled in sexuality and things like that. Like, we were renowned for wearing dresses and things. And those dresses became a biggest cliche as what we first tried to do was, like, in wearing the dresses. So everyone wanted us to just wear these things and wanted us to do this and be anarchists. And that became we were becoming boring old farts, which we set out not to be. So I ended it. That was a band I formed when I came out of school. I think it was sort of 16 and a half, 17. And it was like an eight-year relationship breaking up, so I was really confused. And that's why, like, painting sort of brought me back down to find out who I was. And I did do some recordings with people in the, like, Mark Smith from The Fall, who's an old friend of mine going way back to sort of 78. And I did some recording with The Fall. And Dave Ball from Ex-Soft-Cell was an old friend, and it was just doing things with people I liked and got on with. And after I painted, I started a cabaret in Dublin called the Blue Jays, which was a sort of a vaudevillian experience. And then hence onto Island Records.
Kills the thing he loves. By each let this be heard. Some do it with a bit.
What is falling in love? Falling in love. To fall is an error, you know, a mistake, you know, end up getting your head broken, neck broken, everything, you know. I much prefer to grow in love, you know. Make sure you have roots.
The love when they are young, some when they are old, some strangle with the hands of lust, some the hands of gold. The kindest use a knife because the dead so soon grow cold.
The first single from the album is the title track, Each Man Kills the Thing He Loves. It's not like, if you read the poem, it's quite a remorse, an intense, sad lyric. But we didn't see it like that. We gave it almost sort of a joyous type of vaudevillian, sort of circus type of a feel, because love is like a bloody circus. People running around like clowns after each other, falling in love and breaking their hearts and not knowing who or what they are or where they're going.